My dear students, I'm very happy to see you here again. Thank you so much for joining me at yet another Russian language lesson. In this video, in this lesson, I'm gonna tell you a little bit of Russian history, Russian language history, and I will teach you some numbers, so from 1 to 10. In the second half of the video, you will be taught some of the phrases and common words that you could be able to use in the future that could be helpful for you in the future or just for fun. So, let's start. So, once again, today's topic is Russian language or Русский язык. Russian language is a Slavic language spoken primarily in Russia, Belarus, Kazakhstan and Kyrgyzstan. I will be referring to some of my notes here. I hope you don't mind that, just to make it proper. So, Russian belongs to the family of Indo-European languages, and it is one of the three living members of the East Slavic languages. It's one of the six languages of the United Nations. And it is the most geographically widespread language in Eurasia, having over 144 million native speakers in Russia, Belarus, and Ukraine. Also, it is the eighth most spoken language by native speakers, and the fourth one most spoken by non-native or just speakers, basically. Not necessarily native speakers, that rephrase it like that. There are some dialects in Russian language as well as in any other languages. These dialects are mostly divided into two regional groupings: Northern and Southern. In these dialects, you can always see distinct and non-standard features in pronunciation, in intonation, in vocabulary overall, and the grammar. Some of these dialects are really like relics of ancient usages, but unfortunately, most of them are completely discarded by current standard languages. So, as far as Northern Russian dialects, those are usually spoken along the river Volga, from north down to the south, and typically these dialects pronounce a sound O very clearly, which is called Okanye. And in the Southern Russian dialects, unstressed E and followed by A is not pronounced as E as it's supposed to, it's pronounced as a A, and therefore is pronounced as a Ya. It's a little bit complicated to explain right now, because you need to go a little bit deeper into the Russian language to probably explain it. And it's called yakanya, and it's used in some forms of the sentences, so we'll leave it there. So there are two dialects, major dialects. As far as some history behind Russian language, judging by historical records, by approximately 1000 AD, the predominant ethnic group of the most European Russia, Ukraine, and Belarus nowadays have been speaking relatively close kind of a dialect to Russian language, so that it takes place long time ago. Then it has been adopted by Christianity and firstly started in times of Kievan Rus. It has been commercialized into a native commercial language back then in 988, but then the languages started to have differentiations in them after the breakup of the Kievan Rus, which took place in the 1100s, and therefore our languages split into parts, two separate ones. So as far as for numberings, I'm gonna zoom you in a little bit, just to show you a little bit more up close the numbers. I hope you can see them all. Okay, so we're gonna learn how to say numbers from 1 to 10 today. So right now I have only 5, and I will include the other 5 later. Let's start with the first one. Let me just read it to you. It's 1 is один, 2 is два, 3 is три, 4 is четыре, 5 is пять, 6 is шесть, 7 is семь, 8 is восемь, 9 is девять, and 10 is десять. Один, два, три, четыре, пять. Let's write it first in Russian. Один. I'm gonna write this type of a D letter sound there, because it's a little bit easier. Usually you would write it a little bit differently, but just for you to understand it better for now, I'll write it this way. And this is in Russian, I'm writing right now. Один. I would like to explain to you right away what I'm going to be doing. Today I will try to teach you how to say these words and sentences easier in English without complicating them into transcriptions like I did in the last video. I will try to use a form of a translate instead of a transcription. So, in translate, you would write down it this way. Один. Here is a trick. In this whole video and the next one as well, you will hear me say один, pronouncing this sound as not an O, but as an A. That is due to this portion of the word to be stressed. So this is the letter that is stressed in the word. Therefore, this letter, unstressed, becomes the sound A. So, один. This one is 2, два. In Russian, you would write it this way. Два. In translate, you would write it as this. Два. Three is very close to American pronunciation or any other languages as well. And that would be три. This is a Russian version. In translate, you would write it as this. Три. Very simple. Один, два, три. Four would be четыре. It's a little bit more complicated number. Oh, let me write it first in English. In Russian, sorry. Четыре. In translate, you will write it as such. two, three, three, четыре. Let's pronounce it together. Четыре. Okay. And number five will be пять. Which is in translate, written the following way. Now, here's a trick. Do you see how I wrote down pet? You could try and pronounce it as a pet, probably, with the sharp T in the end. But, because in this case, we're using a soft sign, which in Russian language softens the letter standing in front of it. Therefore, it creates a softer version of a T sound, te, in this word. So, it will be not pyat, but pyat. So, I would write an extra sound here. You will not usually write it down, but when you pronounce it, you would try and put it in the word, so it's going to be pronounced properly. So, it's pyat, pyat. I read it. Один, два, три, четыре, пять. Very good. Now we're going to go to the rest of the numbers. Let me just wipe off the desk. I hope it's easy for you to understand it at this point. Russian is a pretty complicated language, but everything is doable, right? Okay. So, now numbers from 6 to 10. Or 6, 7, or 7, 8, or 8, 9, or 9, and 10, or 10. 6. Again, you see the soft sign in the end? That will soften the sound ta in this case. So, it will be written this way in translate. Hope you can see it. Шесть. But again, remember that when you're pronouncing it, you will be pronouncing it softer. Like if you would say a sound, so it would be шесть. No, семь. And you see it's softened in the end again, yet one more time with the soft. In translate, it will be written the same this way. Семь, but once again, I would strongly recommend you try and soften it up. So I would put this piece right here, just to stress the softness of the M in the end. So let's try to pronounce it. Шесть, семь. Восемь or eight. Восемь. Again, soft sign in the end. It doesn't have any pronunciation. It's actually called soft sign. Восемь. And translated will be four. Again, soft, soft M. Восемь. Try to pronounce it. Восемь. Very good. Девять. Or nine. Or in translate it will be with the silent Z, sort of to say. Девять. Again, because of the silent sound here. Девять. And the last one, десять, also with the soft T in the end. So it's десять. I hope it's easy to understand so far and easy to follow. And translate will be the following way. Yet what again? A softer silent T. T with the C here. So, десять. And let's try to go from top down. Okay? So, шесть. Семь. Десять. Now we can try to pronounce it all together from 1 to 10. One. Two. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine. Один, два, три, четыре, пять, шесть, семь, восемь, девять, десять. And now we're going to move on to the second half of the video.